So this video is part one of our DIY septic system install.
Drill the second hole here. So the septic system that we're putting in has 100 foot of leach field divided into two trenches, so two 50 foot trenches. So I'm finally getting around to working on the house location, and it's very exciting. So the first thing we did came out this morning and we set the stakes for the corners of our house. And as you can see kind of down this path here, that's where the septic's going to be. And so we staked all the important kind of locations in the septic. So the tank, the divider box, and both ends of the leach of both leach fields. And so everything's staked. And now my next thing is to use this transit level to get an elevation on all the staked points. And then I'll know where everything is in relation to each other, and I'll record all those elevations and go inside and do some figuring and figure out where I want the elevation of my leach field, my tank, the foundation of my house, all of that kind of stuff. I can get all my elevations figured out before I ever start digging. To do all that with, I've got my transit level set up here. I started out by getting the tripod set up, and I just used a small hand level to get this base leveled out before I ever put the transit on the base. So I got that pretty close to level, and then I put the transit on, and the transit just connects with a bolt underneath. And then you can fine tune with these wheels here on the transit to get the transit perfectly level. Right now I have it set up pretty close where that bubble's right in the middle of the circle telling me that my transit is level. So when I move it from side to side to take the different elevations, it'll be true in relation to each other. You're using a transit, you need someone at the other end holding a stick that has accurate measurements on it, because you're going to be dialing in and seeing exactly where that crosshairs falls and taking that measurement. Holding it like this where I can see the face, and then she's going to put a little torpedo level on the side here and make sure she's got this level. Once she gets it good and level, she'll tell me, and then I'll dial in the transit to where I can see wherever the crosshairs fall and take that measurement. So we just got through shooting the levels for our house pad and our septic, and I was really impressed with this level. April was standing down at the far end of the septic, which is probably 150 feet away, and I could see the markings on that stick she has crystal clear. And I could see within an eighth of an inch easily. I mean, just the optics are excellent. I'm very impressed. I'm starting to dig my leach field here, and this is my first time ever digging a trench with a backhoe. So, and it's really this, renting this backhoe is the first time I've ever used a backhoe very much at all. So I was surprised how easy it was to learn to operate and, you know, use pretty accurately. I'm sure it probably took me longer to do than, you know, a professional would, but I felt like I was able to, you know, make a pretty reasonably straight trench that was, you know, pretty accurate as far as depth. I stopped occasionally and took another transit level shot of it to verify that I was going the depth that I needed. So, but this was a fun project. Don't be intimidated about renting a backhoe. You can learn pretty quickly. So from my use of the transit level, I was able to determine that I needed to dig about 5.5 to 6 feet deep a trench. Pretty much all the way down, and so that's what I'm doing here. I needed to put my gravel in 3 feet deep, and then the leach pipe goes on top of that, and then it has to be covered with a few inches of gravel, so that's basically another 6 inches of gravel on top of that, and then you need about 1.5 feet of cover on top of that, so that gets you to that 5.5 foot, 6 foot deep range. So that's what I was targeting here as I was digging these leach field trenches. We purchased 52 tons of leach field gravel, and that should be enough to fill the 100 total feet of trench that we have to a height of 42 inches, and still have a little bit left over. I found out that it's critical to get your elevations correct in relation to each other. So the elevation of the septic tank in relation to the leach field is a critical measurement there that has to be right. And so I actually had to sit down with a piece of paper and draw it all out with the elevations and figure out exactly what it needs to be, because you end up needing to be within a couple inches of exactly the correct elevation relative to the other part of the system. So that is definitely a critical measurement. When I dug out the leach tank area, originally I dug it too deep. I went about 4 inches too deep, so I had to backfill all that by hand and wet it and compact it and everything to make sure that it was perfectly right and I had that elevation just right before I put the system together. This is the septic tank that we'll be using. It's an Infiltrator 1060, and basically it meets the requirements for a 1,000-gallon septic tank, which is what our septic survey called for. It'll be the right size for our house. And I decided to go with this Infiltrator model as opposed to a precast concrete, just because it's lighter, easier to handle. I can set it myself, move it around, and mess with it, do it all myself, whereas a precast concrete, you have to be prepared and ready when they come set it, and then once they set it, you know, you can't move it by yourself because they're really heavy. They're about the same cost. This was about $1,200, and from what I understand, the precast concrete were about the same price. So one thing I need to do now is I need to drill the holes for the inlet and outlet. This flat spot is where you drill. There's a little notch there. Just line that pilot drill up and drill in. I'll do that here in just a second. It calls for a 5-inch hole saw, and I was able to find a 5-inch hole saw that was rated, you know, for wood or plastic at Harbor Freight. Came in a kit, actually, for $15 for like 8 different sizes, including the 5-inch size. So it was ridiculously cheap, and it ought to work for what I'm doing here. It's thicker than I thought it was. I'm impressed. The tank comes with a set of accessories that's on the inside of the tank. So you have to pop the top when you get it. And inside there's a bag of stuff. And included in that bag is this rubber gasket. There's two rubber gaskets, basically one for the inlet, one for the outlet. There's also some internal kind of a drop pipe for the inlet and the outlet too. I'm about to install this rubber gasket here. So I drilled my 5-inch hole. And this gasket should just kind of push right in. It does, that went in easy. It goes up to this gasketed surface here, and it's ready to go. Now I just put a little lube on here and then push my pipe through, and it should be a watertight seal. Here's how thick this tank was, like I was. Here it is. This is the piece I cut out of it. It's pretty substantial. I would say it's close to 1/4 inch thick, so pretty impressive. And drill the second hole here. Thank you. So the septic system that we're putting in has 100 foot of leach field divided into two trenches, so two 50-foot trenches. And so since we're dividing the outlet of the septic tank into two different trenches, you need a divider box. So it's called a DBox, and this one I ordered online, what they call a four-hole DBox, basically into three trenches, one out of each side and one out the front. And then they also make a plug that you can plug one side. Unfortunately, this one came with only three holes, as you can see, instead of four. So this is called a four-hole box, and it only has three holes. It doesn't have the hole that I need, and I only need three holes, and the reason I can't make do with the three that are there is because the inlet hole has to be 2 inches higher than the outlet holes. And so the three holes that are drilled into it currently are outlet holes, and I don't have an inlet hole. So I'm going to have to drill another hole in it, 2 inches higher than the other holes, as my inlet hole. Another thing that's a little bit unfortunate is the holes that they come pre-drilled are 4 3/4, and I can't find a 4 3/4 hole saw anywhere. So I'm going to have to just drill it out with a 4-inch hole saw and then use a jigsaw or something to cut the hole. And then they have these rings, different colored rings, to fit different size pipes that you can snap into the box here. I think the blue is for schedule 40, and the yellow is for thin wall or schedule 35. And you can get different size, whatever you need to make the pipe that you're going to be using fit properly. So I'm going to drill this hole, and then I'll be installing my D-box. All right, so here's the finished product. I cut the hole and put in the blue one, which is for the schedule 40. And then I'm going to have the inlet coming in here, schedule 40. One of the outlets will be schedule 40. This one will go directly into the leach field, so it'll be the schedule 35, and then a plug on this side. So it's all done and ready to put in the trench. Now that I have the tank set, I am putting some water in it to keep it from floating. If we were to get a significant rain event, this pit could fill up with water, or you could develop some standing water in there, and this tank is really light. It's just polyurethane, so it would float. And so to counter that, we're going to put, a foot or two of water in the bottom so that, if we do get a rain event, that the tank won't move. And that'll also keep it in place as we're starting to do our backfill. It'll keep it from being moved around as we start to pack the dirt in around the base. You actually have to purposefully kind of kick dirt underneath it and pack it down with your feet so that you can get these ribs full of dirt underneath, so it's fully supported all the way around. So you're going to be down there kicking in the dirt, compacting it as you go up, about every 12 inches or so, and having that water in there will keep it from moving while you're, backfilling and compacting. As you can see here, I have a filter that'll go on the outlet. That's that white thing on the top there. There's a blue filter that's a 6-inch by 14-inch. And basically that'll attach to the outlet, 4-inch outlet line that you can see laying there. I'll put that outlet line through the tank. It'll stick through 3 or 4 inches, and then I'll attach the filter to the inside of that. So the water will have to come up through that bottom hole, go up through that filter to exit the infiltrator tank, make sure that it's just kind of pure water or liquid that's leaving to the leach field. So one thing I'm about to start working on now is I'm trying to get this 4-inch schedule 40 PVC pipe into that rubber gasket that I installed earlier. And that rubber gasket is made to where it can fit either a schedule 40 pipe or the 35 thin wall, and so it's difficult to get the bigger schedule 40 pipe in there than it would be to get the thin wall pipe in there. So you have to really stretch the rubber out as it's going in, and it's really difficult. So in fact, I can't do it. So I'm going to have to get the 4-inch, the end of the pipe there, and I'm going to get my knife or some sandpaper and develop a bevel on the edge, a kind of a 45 degree bevel that'll make it a lot easier to start it into that rubber gasket. So hopefully that will help. And then I'll also lube it up good with some dish soap, and hopefully I'll be able to get it in there. Mm-hmm. I just now put the filter on, and for right now I'm just dry fitting it. I'm actually not sure if it needs to be glued or not. I'll research that, but for right now I'm just getting it ready for the first inspection. And for the first inspection, I just have to have the tank set and the distribution box set with the connecting pipe, and they have to be, you know, set at their proper elevation and level. So anyway, that's why I went ahead and dry fit the inlet filter on, and now I'm going to set the D-box in its place. Okay, so I'm about to get my D-box set in place, and so when I do that, I want to make sure that I'm getting at least 2 inches of drop from the tank to the D-box. And codes are different everywhere, but 2 inches is typically good enough. This is about a 13-foot stretch from the tank to the D-box. I'm going to shoot from 2 to 4 inch drop to the inlet of my D-box. And then I'm going to square my D-box, get it totally level, and I'm going to use that bag of QuickCrete there, and I'm going to create a concrete base to hold that D-box perfectly level so it won't shift when you're backfilling. It just creates a good, secure place for that D-box to sit and not move, because you want it to remain level, of course, so that the water diverts equally to both septic fields. To do what they, I believe what they call a dry set on this D-box. Basically, I'm going to have it set to where I've dug out a hole deeper than my D-box, and I'm going to put some dry concrete into that hole. And then I'm going to attach the D-box to my inlet pipe, and I'm going to kind of settle it in that dry concrete mix until it's the perfect level. Then I'm going to shoot some elevations, make sure that's exactly where I want it. And when it is, I'm going to slowly add water to that concrete to make that concrete set. And then I'll have my D-box set firmly on a concrete pad.
That's it for now. Check back in to see if we passed inspection and for the rest of the septic install. Like and subscribe and click the little bell so you will get a notification when the next video comes out. Thanks for watching.